Welcome to Bethlehem Institute of Engineering. Bethlehem Institute of Engineering is affiliated to Anna University, Chennai and approved by AICTE, New Delhi. This institution was established in the year 2008.
Good morning, students. Today we are going to see a topic about beam. Okay, beam is a flexural member. Beam is also called as a flexural member. Beam. What is beam? Beam is a structural element. It may resist a bending load, so it is called as a flexural member. Beam. There are two types of beams. That is single reinforced beam and double reinforced beam. The difference between the single reinforced beam and double reinforced beam is if the tension side. The beam is split into two zones, that is compression zone and tension zone. Compression zone, the diagram, this diagram clearly shows bottom side is a tension zone and top side is called as a compression zone. Okay, if the reinforcement is provided only on the tension zone, that is tension zone is nothing but the bottom side, it is called as single reinforced beam. The second diagram shows it is a double reinforced section. If the reinforcement is provided on both the sides, it is called as double reinforced section. The reinforcement will be provided on tension zone and as well as in compression zone, it is called as double reinforced beam. Okay, then the beams definitions. Okay, overall depth, that is beam full depth is called as overall depth. From the top end to the bottom end, it is called as overall depth. Okay, effective depth is nothing but it is denoted from top edge till the reinforcement center. In this diagram it is clearly given that four reinforcements are provided, right, and the round shape is called as reinforcement. If the effective depth is nothing but from the top end to the center of the bottom reinforcement ka center varaiku irunda, that is called as effective depth. Okay, then clear cover is nothing but in this diagram you clearly have that clear cover is nothing but bottom reinforcement lende reinforcement bottom to bottom of the reinforcement to the bottom of the beam, it is called clear cover. And next one is effective cover is nothing but center of the reinforcement, bottom center of the reinforcement till the bottom, it is called as effective cover. Okay, next is it neutral axis, there's a beam split two types here. This diagram shows a neutral axis diagram. It splits the reinforcement, the beam, into two zones, that is compression zone and tension zone. Top it is compression and bottom it is tension. Okay, that is called as neutral axis. Then depth of neutral axis. The depth of neutral axis from the top edge of the beam to the neutral axis is it called as N. Okay, then tensile reinforcement, it is denoted by capital A suffix XT. Okay, if the reinforcement is provided on the tension zone reinforcement, it is called as tensile reinforcement. Compression zone, if we are the reinforcement is provided on the compression side, it is called as compression reinforcement. Then we have three set of beams, that is balanced section, under reinforced section, over reinforced section. Okay, that is balanced section, it is a single. Unbalanced section, we have two types of section, that is under reinforced section and over reinforced section. This is the difference. This diagram shows the difference between the under reinforced section, balanced section and over reinforced section. Okay, that if the critical neutral axis, your normal neutral axis meets the critical neutral axis in a certain particular point, it is called as balanced section. In a beam we have a neutral axis. Okay, in that neutral axis, if the critical neutral axis meets at the same point of actual neutral axis, we have two types of neutral axis, that is actual neutral axis, that is the center of the beam, and if the critical neutral axis meets the stress drain diagram meets at the same point, it is called balance section. The section is balanced in compression zone and also in tension zone. Then second one is under reinforced section. Under reinforced meaning is if the reinforcement is lower, if the reinforcement is less, okay, if we provide less reinforcement in the beam, it is called as under reinforced section. Reinforcement is, we have lesser reinforcement, then your critical neutral axis, your section will fail at the compression zone. If you have clearly seen, neutral axis is failing on the compression zone, that is on the bottom side of the reinforcement, because we have lesser reinforcement, okay. Then if the reinforcement is provided on the next zone, that is next thing is over reinforced section, if the over reinforced section, the over reinforced section shows we have the greater reinforcement, then it will fail on the reinforcement shown, that is bottom side of the reinforcement, then it is called as over reinforced section, okay. These are the three differences between the under reinforced section, over reinforced section and balance section. We have three in this design. We design for balance section or under reinforced section, okay. Then already I have explained in the diagram, if n value is less than nc, that is your actual neutral axis is less than critical neutral axis, it is called as under reinforced section, okay. Then for balance section, n value is equal to nc, that is actual neutral axis is equal to critical neutral axis. For over reinforced section, your n is greater than nc, that is actual neutral axis is greater than critical neutral axis, then it is called as over reinforced section, okay. Then we have two methods for solving the design. One is working stress method and another one is limit state method. Nowadays in practice we are using only limit state method, not working stress method, because working stress method is an ancient method. First, while designing a beam, first ancient time they are used only working stress method for a design. Now they are using limit state method. It is an advanced method compared with working stress method. What are the difficulties and problem faced in working stress method is rectified and solved and designed as working stress method, okay. That is first working stress method, they will reduce the stress. If concrete will attain 20 newton per mm square, they are consider that as 5 newton per mm square and they will continue the design. So it is called as uneconomical design, okay. If a concrete will attain M20 concrete will attain a strength 20 newton per mm square in 20 days, but in working stress method they will consider only 7 newton per mm square will take, and we will design the design, then the section will become a bigger size and an uneconomical section, okay. Then in working stress method they will consider the safety factor only. They will consider only the safety factor, but in limit state method they will consider each and everything, that is excess loads and safety, everything is considered in limit state method, okay. It clearly shows design criteria in working stress method, design criteria will be taken in stresses, and here it is taken as load increases, load konja adhigama vachi design panirpanga. Then working stress method is a simple method and limit state method is an advanced method, and it uses it work for serviceability. Serviceability is nothing but it will go for a lifelong period of time, okay. Then 11th this point indicates that working stress method, the section size will be a very greater, and in working stress, in the limit state method, it is a nominal size and it is an economical design. These are the some differences that is based on working stress method and limit state method, okay. Thank you.